battlefield. Hear me. Wedding is an official initiation into marriage. Somebody say official initiation. Wedding is a glamorous convocation into the university of marriage. Marriage is an institution that has a date of admission without a date of graduation. So when you enter, you don't enter. Now one chance. Marriage is one chance. What did I call it?
One chance.
Once you enter, no going back. No turning back. God value marriage so much. And that is why he duplicates family here on earth. Let us make man in our own image. And he creates man and woman, Adam and Eve. And when Jesus came, Jesus solidified marriage by making us to understand that he is the head of the church. He's the head of this union. Who is the head of this union? So Jesus addresses us as a husband and wife. He addresses the church as marriage. Hear me? And hear me good. Who do I marry? Number one. Marry a helpmate. Somebody say helpmate. Do not marry mate mate. Marry help mate. Help. Somebody say help. 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 There is something you can't do for yourself. And you need a helper. As a man, can you give birth to children by yourself? Can you pregnant yourself and give birth to children by yourself? Can your mother replace it? Can your father replace it? And that is why you don't equate your love. Those that are married here, the love for your wife cannot be equated to the love you have for your mother or your father. For this purpose shall a man leave his father and his mother. My own language. For this purpose shall a man abandon his father and his mother and cleave to his wife. Some of you here that are still living like Bongoan. You are married, but your mother controls you. You love your mother more than your wife. You even beat your mother, I mean your wife, because you talk to your mother. You are breaking the scripture. For this purpose, you must leave your father, leave your mother, and cleave to your wife. Both of you shall become one. It's only a fool that beat his wife. Any man that slap woman is a fool. It's in the Bible. I'm not the one that said it. Hear me? In Genesis chapter 2 verse 18, the Bible says, and the Lord just said, it is not true that the man should be alone. I will make for him a helpmate. Who suggested marriage? Who suggested marriage? Who introduced marriage? Institute marriage. When God says it's not true, it's not true. And that is why no woman is single in this world. Every woman have a husband. Every man have a wife. Because that is the plan of God. Adam and Eve. It's not Adam and Steve. Are you hearing me? Not Adam and what? Adam and what? Eve, not Steve. I will make for him a helper. So what are we helping? That means you have a weak point, every man. Tell your neighbor, the man beside you, say you have a weak point. And you need a wife to help you out. Every man. You need a helper. you as a helper.
Make sure you are an asset to a man.
What did I call you?
Asset.
Asset. Don't be a liability. A liability. Any woman that is a liability, no man will marry her. Everybody needs asset. Because the Bible says you are a helper. What are you?
What are you?
Every woman is a helper. Not a leper. There are so many women that are lepers. Instead of being a helper. It's an error for as a wife to be calling your husband giving money for Maggie. Salt. Salt not the house. Maggie not there to buy salt. Are you in the house from January to December? Busy doing nothing. It's an error. What did I say that?
Error.
It's an error. You're supposed to be a helper. How are you helping your husband? To those that are married, how are you helping your husband? Which area? To help him to squander his money. You help him wasting his money in iPhone 7. Help him wasting the money Brazilian has on buying the latest car in town. Hear me? Don't marry a dictator for a wife. I'm going to talk to both men and women. Are you hearing me? Someone said both. So that we cannot be one sided. Don't marry what? Those of you from the back, what did I just say?
Huh?
A dictator. There are women that control their husband. They are make their husband remote. Ordinary, you people are just doing boyfriend or girlfriend or fiancé, whatever. And you are controlling your man. You are not even entering the house. You are the one detecting who to talk with and who not to talk with. Who are you? Don't talk to this one. Why did you talk to him? That your friend won't go. Don't talk to him. Don't talk to them. Why did you smile at that woman? That girl, you talk, I saw you smile. You can't you smile. Why did you smile? He said, oh, honey, I did it. And if you make any noise, okay, we will see. When you marry a dictator, you have to kneel down before you sleep with her. When you marry a dictator, she will say, okay, you love me, you want to make love? Okay, I need this. Buy me a handbag. Say, okay, I'll buy you. Okay, go run downstairs, go and make tea for me. You run, go and make tea. She said, okay, sit down. Go wash those underwears. Underwears. Wash up, wash up. You have entered one. A dictator! She wants to control you. She wants to tell you. Run! If you are in any relationship, a broken relationship is better than a broken marriage. It is better you break that relationship now than to allow it to become married. Because if you can begin to dictate now, telling me who to go with and who not to go, you have not gone to the house yet. I'm not married. Your father don't know me. Your mother don't know me. Your cousin. Nobody know me. It's just me and you. And you are dictating. The journey is far. Every woman is an incubator. When you give woman a word, she will give you a settle. When you give woman a settle, she will give you a book. When you give woman a book, she will give you an encyclopedia. When you give woman a sperm, she will give you a baby. They are incubator. And that is why when you tell a woman one word, she will carry that one word. Take it to her lab. She will diagnose that word. Why did you make that comment? Your sister just made a comment. That who are you dating? And you said, is from so part of Nigeria. And she said, to be careful with those people. A comment, phone conversation, and you might grab it. So that comment that has been made, come and explain. Explain! Hear this. I hear it clear. Any woman that makes money has first priority. She will rather end up with Isaiah 4:1. Any woman, all the women they ask, listen for your own good. I pity those that miss the service. Any woman that loves money more than marriage, you make money your first priority rather than marriage, you will end up with Isaiah 4. Let's read. On that day, several women shall cry to one man, and they will say,
we eat our own food.
We have made money. We will eat our own food. We will buy all our own clothes. Only let us be called by Okonkwo Angelina, so that you can take away the reproach from my life. People have been mocking me. That what am I still waiting for? I said it the other day. When a young lady is growing up, they will ask you, who is your father? When there is a state to be grown to, they will ask you, who is your husband? Are you hearing me? So when you love mommy, a lot of women have missed their husband because of this thing called money. They miss the right man. Because they see you. 80% of women judge men by what they see now. What they see now. Who are you? Where do you work? How much is do you earn? How much do you have in savings? Can you take care of my shoe alone? Can you buy me a shoe? Look at my phone, iPhone 7. Can you afford this phone? Hello? Life is not all about today. Life is not all about now. Tomorrow is bigger than today. Tomorrow is greater than today. The person you see on the floor today might be on the top tomorrow. Don't judge people by what you see them now. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
There are people that you are looking up to today. If they show you their past, you won't associate with them. There are men you are dying for today. If they show you their past, you won't even go close. You will even reject them. Say, God forbid.